You seem to be taking our client's infidelity kind of personally.
How's that?
Well, Elena was having a difficult time, and you didn't comfort her, and the Higgins I know has more empathy than that.
Okay, so she makes a commitment to a man who she then betrayed. I mean, excuse me if I don't jump at the opportunity to make her feel better.
So Ethan isn't cheating on you?
What? No.
You're not cheating on him?
No! Honestly, Magnum, enough with this ludicrous third degree.
I'm just saying, I'm here if you want to talk.
Gee, thanks. I would like to talk about work, if that's right. According to the text records in Eddie's burner phone, Elena wasn't the only woman that he was pursuing. In the last 6 months, he's had a string of affairs with 6 different women, all of whom were married.
Guy certainly has a type.
Yeah, or a death wish. Manipulated wives and angry husbands make for a long list of enemies.
Yes, but our Vic was killed by 2 men who were looking for something, right? Not quite ready to connect his death to the affairs yet.
No, I agree. We're missing something, definitely.
Why would Eddie stalk these women for months, only to date them for a couple weeks and then move on?
It is odd. There doesn't appear to be a jilted partner. The lovebirds make plans to see one another again, and then communication just stops completely.
Well, everybody except this woman, Mia Collins. Look at her last text to him.
I'm not paying you a cent.
What if he was blackmailing them?
Well, that would certainly explain the interest in married women and the sudden halt in communications.
Can you pull up his financials?
Yeah. Oh, here, look. Several large cash deposits in his recent bank statements. And the dates, yeah, they all correspond with the end of each of the affairs.
I think we need to pay Mia a visit. I mean, she's the only one who refused to play ball. Maybe she hired muscle to recover whatever leverage Eddie had on her and ended up with a more permanent solution to the problem.